What's up, guys? It's the Red Herring, and welcome to 007 Bloodstone Part 3. Still in... I forget where this place is. And now driving a car. So I know I said in the last part that I would hopefully be back the next day, which was yesterday. But, clearly I wasn't. My plan had been to record after dinner, and I basically just got sidetracked for about 3 hours. And by that point it was, like, I just didn't have the energy to, to record and edit in one night. So, you know, I waited a little, and here I am the next day. And I hope that's okay. If not, well, I mean, it's what happens, so you really don't have a choice. I will say, though, I think the driving parts of this game are possibly one of my favorite parts. Or some of my favorite parts, I should say. Now, some of them aren't great. There is one in... I think it's Hong Kong. That I'm not really a fan of. But in my defense, in not liking that one, you're driving a dump truck. Like, it's a big departure from the ones where you're driving an Aston Martin. Or, I think, one of them you're driving a Lamborghini or something. So, you know. It's kind of an anticlimactic one. Which isn't to say it's bad. It's still... Wait, you're not driving a dump truck. You're driving a tow truck. You're chasing a dump truck. In the other one. Anyway. It's still kind of anticlimactic compared to the other ones. Also, I do have to say, I'm not doing as well with this as I used to. Oh no, my car, it's destroyed. Something that I forgot about that bit, you actually have no steering. Even in like the 4 seconds before the game takes control of the camera and everything and turns it cinematic. So that was amusing to find 2 seconds ago. And that's the end of that part, folks. No, not really. We've got to keep chasing Bernin. Or is it Bernin? No, either way. Yeah, make sure I'm dead. That's a good plan. Wouldn't want Bond to still be alive. Can you hear me? Come in, 007. Oh, it's unsuppressed. That is unfortunate. I did not get his gun, which is unfortunate. Oh wow, that counts as a different weapon? Really? Fuck. What? Oh. There we go. Really? You shot at me with a shotgun, you asshole? Go to hell. Oh, Oh, wait, you already did. Oh, fuck. Really? I highly doubt that your baseball cap took a bullet and saved your life. Oh, fuck. But I guess it did. In any case, I'm switching to the AK. Because rifles. So there's one thing that I wish you could do in this game, and you can't. And that is, I really wish you could switch your pistol out. Because there's not a lot of places that I would actually do it. It's usually good to have a suppressed weapon. At least, I like to have a suppressed weapon, whether it actually is good or not. But this is definitely one level where I would, because you're restricted to having unsuppressed weapons anyway. So the pistol really loses its only positive side. At least to me. Didn't one of these guys have an assault rifle? No. Oh wait, no, he did. And I got his ammo. Sweet. Oh, fuck. Aw, I hoped he would fall down. He did not fall down. Would it be good if he did, though? Oh, fuck. And what was his gun? I think it might have been a rifle. It was not a rifle. What's over here? Oh, laptop. Oh, fuck. Come on. See, I don't think that would really have had the effect that they were wanting. Also, I have to say, some of the controls in this game, particularly for when it wants you to do a specific thing, like that, really fucking finicky. Because I pressed A, and it would then move me out from where it wanted me to press it from. Without counting it. But, yay, shit happens. If at first the game fucks you, try and try again. And it will still continue to fuck you. But you'll get more pleasure. Oh wait, it's not that kind of fucking. Wrong button. He's gonna move around the truck. He's not gonna move around the truck, I guess. I thought he was. Okay, well, I'm gonna switch back to the rifle then. And take out all these motherfuckers. Good. Not good. still use more ammo than I wanted to use. And see, this is when it kind of bugs me. Also, I managed to take out the grenade launcher guy. I now have to switch from the AK because none of the enemies have it. And I'm not going to. I'm going to be a stubborn bastard. And then waste all the ammo that I do have. I think that was an AK. That guy, I'm not so sure. That was not an AK. Son of a bitch. If none of these guys have AKs, I'm gonna switch. Yeah, okay, I'm gonna switch to the MP5. Motherfucker. I mean, the MP5's good. But the AK is so much better. So much more power, so much more accuracy at range. God damn it. Where did I come from? I'll go get some more ammo. That was a pistol. Here's the more SMG ammo. That's the grenade launcher. There we go. And someone else had it, right? Yeah, this guy. Oh, no, that's Fulano. Are you sure no one up here had the AK? Why, sure. Okay. That's unfortunate. Because I was really hoping to keep the AK for a little while longer. But at least I got to kill a couple more people with it. Oh, he also had the... Okay, well, I would have had full ammo without having to go back there, but hey. I think I just shot Burnin in the back. I don't think it actually gave me points for it. Like, I don't think you can actually hurt Burnin until you get to a specific point. I was going to say, I think that guy's got a grenade launcher. But I think some of these guys also have AKs. Maybe. Yes, AKs. I wanted to see if he dropped it and it still detonated. It would have, but I got impatient. Let's scan the helicopter. Yay. That'll do. There's his ammo. And I think that's all I can pick up from there. Yeah. There's still a decent amount of ammo. I'm still happy with that. Where's that guy? Oh. There's the grenade launcher guy. See how much easier it was with the AK? Fucking hell. I really want to still have the AK when I get to the bit at the end. Hey, cool, I actually did damage. I really didn't expect to do damage there, if I'm honest. See, I forgot that unlike the last game, if you run into a guy, You don't automatically take him down. Uh-huh.
I want a name. Who are you working for?
Never.
Let's try that again. Who is it? Who hired you? Give me a name.
Pomeroy. Stefan Pomeroy.
Where's he taking those papers?
I don't know. I've told you everything I know. Please.
I think the timing might be slightly off. Just ever so slightly. Kick him off the edge. Kick him off the edge.
I'm no good to you anymore.
You got that right.
I forgot he actually did that. I'm so happy.
What is it, 007? Did you intercept the research?
No. The researcher is dead. But I've got the name of the buyer.
That's always handy.
Pomeroy. Stefan Pomeroy.
Okay, so this is the path that takes you to Siberia. Nope. Monaco.
According to the immigration data, he's in Monaco, due to leave on a...
Oh, no, it's Moscow, not Siberia.
I'm sending you his picture and file.
Got it. Let's get in touch with our best contact in Monaco.
I think there's a level in Siberia. Is there not?
See if he can stall Pomeroy from leaving and have him meet me at the airport.
Of course.
Good. I'll be on the next flight out.
Maybe there's not. That's going to bug the shit out of me.
Sorry, have we met before?
I think once. Something in England. Nicole Hunter.
Oh, no, I think this is still Monaco. I think the next level's Siberia.
I've been called worse. It girl, socialite.
Anyway.
Nice to see you, Nicole. I'm sure you've got a plane to catch.
Actually, M sent me.
Interesting cover. But not an unpleasant surprise. Here we go.
The car's over there.
I like this car.
It's a friend's. Would you like to drive? I feel much safer with a man behind the wheel.
This is the car that's really good that I like to drive. May not be a Lamborghini. Oh, it's Kozniak. There we go.
He's such a lech. But he's kind of sweet, your basic Russian oligarch. He owns oil wells, diamond mines.
It's been a long time since I played this game.
Plated fittings, of course.
How do you know him?
Sweetie, there are only 6 people worth dating in the world, and I've probably gone out with half of them. Turn here.
Wow, she's fucking shallow.
Okay. The truth is, he supplies the chemicals used to alloy the gold and silver in my line of jewelry. And he's been after me to open a boutique in the casino he just bought in Monaco.
He bought a casino?
Mm-hmm. Another trinket on the must-have list for oligarchs. After a supermodel wife. So, I got him to delay his flight back to Siberia.
Hey, to Siberia. I was right.
And we're going to meet in the boardroom, which should give you enough
time. Okay, I feel better now. It confused me.
Well done. So how did you
end up in bed with MI6?
Well, that's one way of putting it.
Darling.
Very effective way of putting it.
Fashion shows, photo shoots, store openings. I get to travel the whole world, and nobody pays any attention.
Emma approached you?
Not exactly.
Well, how not exactly?
Well, there was this little tax problem a few years ago.
A little tax problem.
And that'd do it.
A small customs problem involving some diamonds.
But that's how a girl on the society pages ends up working for him.
Okay, yeah, that definitely would do it.
But believe me, when necessary, I can be very discreet. You can drop me off in front
of me. Sure. Very discreet.
I'm going to put on my war paint before the meeting. I'll text you on the cell phone to let you know when we're almost finished.
So, I might call it here, because from memory, this level is a pretty long one. So, yeah, that's the end of this part. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope you come back whenever the next one is done. And I hope that will be tomorrow. See ya.